Again, Attorney Steve here with another hot tip for building your brands and launching your business. One of the hardest things to do from a trademark perspective is to pick a good company name. Picking a good company name. You don't want to pick something that everybody else has, or they have one in Atlanta. They have, let's say you pick ABC Tacos, and there's one in Atlanta, there's one in Seattle, there's one in New York, and you want to start one in Phoenix, Arizona. So you want to try to get something that's unique from a trademark perspective, something that's sort of arbitrary and fanciful, something a little bit different, okay? And from a domain buying perspective, it's tough to find really good domain names that haven't been taken, especially the .coms, which are the highly coveted things. But I'm going to show you a little idea, not to say it's going to be perfect, not to say it's going to work for you 100%. If any of you out there are Scrabble players, you may be familiar with the website WinEveryGame.com. WinEveryGame.com. You see it right up here in the browser. Okay, you may be aware of it. Type that in and do this. Take two names, two words for your company. Say you're going to sell orange. You want to sell orange hats. Just type orange hats in the bar there, and you can even choose what you would like your company name to start with. You may say, well, you know, it would be pretty cool out of these letters. I'd like it to start with H-O. That might be kind of cool. Then press Find Words. And you can actually put what you want it to end with, too. If you wanted to end with an S. Or you say, you know, it'd be neat to have a company end in a G. That doesn't happen very often. Find Words. See what it comes up with. And it comes back with all these words. And you can see, here's 7-letter words, 6-letter words. Obviously, in domain names, you want to try to buy the shorter the domain, the better. So here's some for you, you know, and you can kind of look on here and say, is there anything interesting? Sarong. Have you ever heard of a company called Sarong or Satang? I haven't. So then you can take that and you can say, wow, that's pretty interesting. So, you know, take that, cut and paste that. Open up a new browser, GoDaddy. That's where I buy domains anyway. You can buy them anywhere you want. But actually, I was surprised. I told someone the other day that in the executive club, I'm buying domains for $8 and $8.19. And the guy was actually pretty shocked. I was talking to a guy from Bluehost. He couldn't believe it. I said, yeah, that's why I buy them here. But you can go and check something like Satang. Has somebody got that domain? Do they? Well, they do, but you can buy it here for $250. Anyway, this you can get Satang.guru, you can get some of these other ones. But it's just a concept of things that you can do. It's another little tool. Again, not to say it's perfect, but you may have some fun with that, and you may actually end up finding and picking your company name just out of this thing. Attorney Steve, if you need a technology, trademark, copyright lawyer, you know where to find me, attorneysteve.net. Thanks for watching.